Hi guys, I'm back with another clothing try-on haul. This time, it is from a brand that I have seen all over YouTube, all over the internet, all over Instagram, and I wanted to try it for myself. I literally spent a good 2 to 3 hours on this website. It was never ending. I probably could have spent more time on it. There was just so much, so much to look at. I initially pronounced it Shine, or Shane. But I think it's actually Shein. I actually haven't watched any YouTube videos for this particular brand. I've only seen the thumbnails and the titles, so I actually haven't heard anyone pronounce it before. I know this is one of those hit and miss websites. What is it on the lens? Oh, that is just my own reflection. Wow. I did my best to find stuff that I would actually wear out, that had good reviews, that would fit me. I actually want this stuff to work. I spent a lot of time trying to find the good stuff. And even if I wanted something really badly, but it had bad reviews, I didn't buy it. This is the box. I don't know how they fit everything in here. I bought a lot, so 5.16 kilos. This is the first thing I found on the website. It is a quilt cover, a duvet cover. Okay, I've just got my order up. I'm actually really excited because I just got reminded of everything that I bought. So this was $40.46. Does it smell weird or anything like that? Oh my god, this is so cute. It is literally just a queen bed cover. Oh my god, look at the inside. That's so cute. I wonder if Risa will like it. A little bit feminine, but that's okay. Just ignore my, oh my god, this is so cute. Oh my god, love it. Oh my god, obsessed with this. Ah! I watch myself back and I'm like, who are you? So annoying. I actually love this checkered print. It is so cute. The fabric feels like a really good quality. It does not feel cheap. It feels like something you'd buy from Kmart. Then I bought another one. This one was $26.96 AUD. This one is a lot more plain. I think, is this reversible? Oh, I'm not sure. This color's not as nice in real life, but I mean, it really doesn't bother me. I'll definitely still use it. And it's got this nice blush color on the inside. It kind of reminds me of like a watermelon. It looks nice against this painting. Everyone always asks who this painting's by. I do not know. I think it might be on the back, but it's really hard to get off the wall and then get it back on. So I would rather not try. Sorry. I think I bought it from Empire Homewares anyway. Again, it doesn't seem to be like bad quality or anything. I would 100% use this. Yeah, damn, that's really good. I think my hopes are pretty low as well since that Pretty Little Thing haul, but these are really good. 100% something you'd find at Kmart, which if you're in America is like a Target. The one thing I really, really liked and appreciated about this website is that they have, for the popular items anyway, lots of comments. By the way, this isn't sponsored, of course, this whole video is not sponsored, but they have lots of comments from people who have bought it and photos from like people of all different shapes and sizes and everything in between wearing it. Wearing all the different items and even just handbags and shoes, and it's so helpful. So helpful. And I get that the people that do that are incentivized, like they have like a point system or something. It's just such a good idea. Such a good idea. This is just a little crop top. My gosh, so cute. I'm wearing this just with some pajama shorts, so ignore that. But this is cute. I mean, like it fits fine in terms of like, it's comfortable, it's not like sucking me in or anything like that. It's got a nice zip, which is good because it means you can actually get into it. Cough, Pretty Little Thing. My issue is with the sleeves, the straps. Ooh, wait, no, it's not meant to be like that, is it? Is it? No. That would be kind of cute though, but no, it's definitely meant to be on the shoulder. And I feel like if I just got a safety pin, oh, cute, that's so much better. And popped that like that, just to put a little pin there. Maybe we could make it work. This top was $7.16. It is a size small. The fabric's like, it's not life-changing quality, but you can't see my bra through it. And for me, that is a plus. Okay, this is cute. I feel like a little Bo Peep, but it is cute, let's be honest. Or like I'm wearing an Oktoberfest costume. This top was $22.45. You know what, I will give it credit though. These cups for your boobs are bigger than most brands. They're still too small for my boobs, but that's not like a surprise. This is a bit weird. It's not, not the most flattering, but what I would do Oh, cute. It's, yeah, tuck it into a pair of like high-waisted jeans or something, or a little skirt. Also, random side note, this zip here, first of all, it has a zip. Since that Pretty Little Thing haul, I really do appreciate a zip or a way to get into the clothing. A zip here, but it actually zips from here down, which is weird because it's like the first time I've ever had a zip like that, but it's amazing. How is that not standard? Because normally you have to be like pulling it up and then it gets hard when you're up here because it's in like an unnatural position. But if you can use your other hand and just go whoop, it's just a swift movement. So I'm appreciative of that. I have no complaints about the quality. Obviously the fit's a little bit weird, but what size did I get actually? Oh, I got a small. Okay. So that is a little bit small for a small, but that's fine. Next we have a bag. I'm going to Bali soon and I wanted just a nice, easy, beachy bag. This bag was $14.35 and it looks like this. This is really cute. Again, when you go on holiday, I don't want to spend like $80 on a bag that I'm going to wear probably like twice a year. I don't wear handbags in general, so the only bags that I have are ones that I bought when I was obsessed with the designer things. It's not suitable for a beachy holiday. So stuff like this that I can buy a one-off, not a huge expense, and hold on to it for years to come and just use it as my holiday bag. I'm about that. So this is how it looks. It's about that big in comparison to my hand. It's also got little handles in case you don't want to use the body strap. I love that this has a zip, especially if you are going to a country that has a history of people snatching things out of your bag. This is just a nice precaution. That means you can, I mean, it's not obviously totally, it's a pretty flimsy bag, but a little bit of peace of mind at least. Ooh, this was $17.06. And I put some denim shorts on. These are I bought them from Revolve. I'm not sure what the brand is. But on another topic, I think I was meant to tie these up more on my shoulder, but this is really nice and easy. And that is what I want with my clothing. It's not, I mean, I don't think it's that transparent. It's not gonna be like completely opaque, but I don't really expect these kinds of tops too, but you just want them to be like light and breezy. If I'm wearing high-waisted pants, it fits nicely just here, so it's not too cropped, it's not too long. I feel like it's a nice length. I am 6'4", 164 centimeters, 163 centimeters on a good day, bad day. Very nice. This top was $7.16. I mean, in the viewfinder, it looks cute. I like the color, I like the pink. It's just, it literally is just a square. There's no shaping or anything for the body. It just digs into my armpits. Can you see how it doesn't go down or anything? It needs to be just a little bit lower there so you don't feel like you've got crunchy fabric right in your armpits. I do like it. It's just, if I'm sweating, it's gonna be, that is just gonna get stinky and sweaty. Gross. Back is also, like, it's, I think it's my boobs. Because my boobs are protruding, it pulls up the fabric, so it's shorter at the front and then longer at the back. It does finish at a pretty good spot for me though, like it's not, it shows a bit of my belly button, it's like a, yeah, I don't know, it's alright. What I like about this as well is that it doesn't make my boobs look huge. A lot of the times, anything with like lines, even if it's just like a checker print or even sewn with lines, it just makes them look humongous and I don't like that. A lot of this stuff reminds me of like a little country girl, like I'm about to hop onto a horse and ride into the wilderness or something. But anyway, next one. Okay, there's a really cute, perfect little bow. Let me try and show you this. This is $11.65. I haven't been saying the sizes. This one is a small, they're pretty much all smalls. The big boobs strike again. As you can see, it's, oh, yeah, it's just, and I don't want to come across as, like, I can imagine how annoying I sound for girls that actually have naturally big boobs that have to deal with it every day. And I opted to get mine, to make mine bigger, and I'm complaining. I don't mean for it to come across like that. It's just that when I was younger, I wanted the bigger look, and now that I'm older, I wish I had them smaller. And you can never predict that happening until you reach that point in your life. I'm still glad I have them. Like, I'd rather have them than not have them, but I'm like a an E or a triple D at the moment, and that's too much for me because I had breast tissue to start with. So I wish I was like a full C probably. When I get them replaced, I will definitely go smaller. If you had smaller boobs, this would be very cute. It's not necessarily about the quality. The quality is fine. It's a little bit see-through in this fabric here, but nothing that really makes me go, ooh, this is terrible. It is a cute top. Let's be honest, it is a cute top. I like the color. I like the length. It's just, it's very dolly. I'm not sure why a lot of this stuff is. I think it just, I don't know why I bought all this stuff. I've unintentionally followed a theme. This bit is a little bit flimsy. Like it's actually not even touching my skin. So that's weird. Maybe that meant to be, I don't know. This one I'm probably the least likely to wear. Ooh, I like the look of this. Medium. Yes on all levels. Love it. Very cute, very cute, very good quality. That is what the back looks like. It's got this elastic band bit here. Tie up straps. Oh my gosh, it's little love hearts. What? These buttons in the middle aren't functional. It was a little bit difficult for me to get on, but we got there in the end. This was $16.16 and I got this in a medium. If I could order again, I would get it in a large. Damn, I haven't worn high-waisted shorts in a while because it's been winter in Australia. They really ride up, hey. Oof. I think I spend more time pulling them out of my bottom than I do wearing them. This stuff is decent quality. I know not all of it is, but this is. Oh my God, the little love hearts are so cute. Next we have another boob tube. For some reason, this one is a lot more comfortable than that pink and white one. I don't know why, but it is a lot more comfortable. Underneath the arms. It must be a different fabric. Maybe that's what it is. This one was $11.65. The other one was $7. Maybe it's a slight difference in quality, but this one is also in a size small. That's the fabric, very stretchy, not see-through. Good enough quality. I'd definitely wear this out. I don't think I like this one very much. $11.65, size small. It was just a nicer color in the photo online. I don't know, just maybe it emphasizes my boobs a bit too much or something. The color is not that great, but the quality is fine. I think this one was quite popular on, like, I had a lot of photos, had a lot of reviews. I like the fact that it's not too low cut. Thank you for that. Appreciate it very much. The sleeves are the perfect length for me, which is very rare. And the length is also lovely. I can tuck it into my shorts and it looks cute and doesn't bunch up in my shorts because it's not super long. The quality is good. It's not super transparent or anything like that. I like the little fringe detailing here. I think that looks quite nice. I would wear this 100% again. No doubt. This is cute. $14.35. One size. What? So cute. Oh my gosh. These sleeves are like a really see-through but light, pretty material. It's got this nice trim here. It's really comfortable around the stomach. It gives me enough space in my boobs. The right length of these shorts. The back I actually can't do up because Reese isn't home and I don't have the coordination to do this on myself. But you tie up the ribbon, which is even cuter. A little white ribbon, and then that's how you get the back to close. Yes, love this. So cute, I love these little sleeves. They're really feminine, but they don't look like I'm trying to dress up for Halloween or for Oktoberfest, or as a fairy, or as a child, or anything like that. They're just, yeah, really pretty. This is easily my favorite thing so far. Okay, big shoes to fill. This top was pretty good. This is cute. Gives you a bit of an arm vagina, but it's kind of hard to avoid with these tops. These little sleeves that you tie up. All of these tops are just easy. That's why I like them. You don't have to think too much about them. Put on some high-waisted shorts, some high-waisted jeans, high-waisted denim skirt, any kind of high-waisted item, and it's just a really easy, no fuss outfit. This was $8.05 and it's a size small. Whoa. This is so cute. Wow. First of all, again, not too low cut because it's got adjustable straps. Fits me nice around my boobs, not smothering, nice around my waist. perfect length, but I'm not wearing heels, which is amazing because I always have to wear heels with like jumpsuits. The split leg is so beautiful. I need to show you this, but I don't know how. That is how it looks. It's got this nice little leg bit. That's the back. And you can wear a bra with it because it's not so low cut, which is so amazing. My problem with these dresses is always that they're really nice at the front. I'm like, yes, I'm gonna buy it. And then I look at the back of the garment and it's like low cut down to here, so you can't wear a bra with it. And I like to wear a bra, so that doesn't ever work with me. Also, I don't know if you saw, but it's got little short bits, so your important areas are covered, and the rest of the fabric, it is like, you know, light and kind of semi-transparent, but it's not bad. I would not look at this and be like, whoa, that's cheap. I'm in love with this. Also, I just checked the price. This was $13.46. This is beautiful. Okay, next item. Oh, and this is a size small. Next, I bought a headband, which I never normally buy, but I was just inspired. I'm not sure if I'm wearing it right. This is my first time. No, I love it. I love it. I love it. It's really comfortable too, which it probably doesn't look like it is, but it's comfortable. It was $5.35. It kind of feels like the same material that the bag was made out of. Okay, this next one is not clothing or an accessory or a bag or anything. Okay, who am I? Go back to my childhood. Look, I know most people would say this is a stupid thing to buy, but just wait for it. Can you see? Yes. I love these things and I haven't seen one in 1,000 years. Oh my God, it's so cool. This will put me to sleep. I will just do this for hours on end. This was $8.35, I think. Makes me feel like extraterrestrial or something. I can guarantee you Reese will hate it. I bought a pair of shoes for $29.65. Crisscross espadrilles. They look pretty good quality. I'm really surprised. I thought this stuff would be like, I don't know. I mean, obviously I tried to get the best stuff, but I still thought it might be a little bit hit and miss, but this has all been pretty good. This is a little bit hard to show, but. I bought a size bigger than I would normally. It must have been sold out in my normal size. So these are a 39, a European 39, I think, which is the perfect size. If I had gotten smaller, that would have been way too small. I'm not in love with these. They're fine. Like the quality is good, which is also quite surprising. Like a solid sole, all of that's good. They look fine on. I guess it's just not really as much my style as I thought it would be. So now I have lots of earrings. Now these range from $2.66 to $5.35. I'll start with the cheapest. These ones here, which are so cute. I love these because they're just creative. They're like melted hoops. I don't even know if my ears still have the hole. These are cute. They kind of might remind me of like a little ghost, unintentionally. These are really fun. Ooh, this is the next pair. That is how those look. This one's got a little dangly bit, and this one's just the chain. So nice. Next is this pair. They're nice. I like this color and that color there. It's like a white and a very light brown. These are by far my favorite. Look at, they've got little Monstera leaves. My gosh, these are everything. And then you've got like a little sequin and bead flower, little diamante, then you got little jewels. Oh, it's so nice. And they move as well. Like they're just dangling off like that. I am in love with these. The Monstera leaves also came in like a yellow and a bright pink, but I don't know why you wouldn't get green. This is my favorite of all the jewelry, and it's actually not even that heavy. You'd think it'd be quite heavy, but it's not. I think they were like $5.60 or something. This is a bikini top. Now it's got like padding, but it's not like a normal, it feels like a makeup sponge inside the padding bit. It's not, it doesn't taper off at the end of the pad. It's like literally a circle that's thick and chunky, and you can probably see it on camera. It's nice that they have padding because most of them don't. but I wish they added like a nicer pad. This set is a small, I'm not gonna show the bottoms because they're way too tight. The actual quality is pretty good though. These are fine, not amazing or terrible, but the bottoms are pretty good. They're just much too small for my bottom. This is the other bikini top. Again, the padding is just wrong. It fits, it's like over, it's got a little tie thing in the bottom, which is cute, but it's giving me under boob and it's not comfortable. And the bottoms are choking me. Like my skin at the moment is going, and that little line there is where the bathers are. It's like so much spillover, cutting off circulation. That is it, my friends. All in all, I was really, honestly, genuinely surprised in a good way with this whole entire haul. Everything, yeah, I'm honestly really genuinely surprised. But as I said, I really did do my best to get stuff that I would actually like and had good reviews and had the best chance of working. I didn't want to buy the bad stuff just to make like a clickbaity video. I genuinely wanted it to work and it pretty much did. I will try and return a few things because some things just don't fit or don't suit me or don't really like. But other than that, I'll pretty much keep most of it. So thank you all so much for watching. I love you guys and I hope to see you all in my next video. Bye.